Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to map store category to Google Merchant Center categories. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. To map our store category to Google Merchant Center category, we'll be using the function category mapping. So click on that. To add a new mapping, click on this button. Once you've done that, it's going to ask you to fill up a merchant. So let's choose Google and let's give it a merchant name. As you can see, when you hover over it, it's telling us that the name needs to be unique and there can't be any space in between. So let's give it a name, Google Mapping. Right now in our category mapping page, we can see all the local categories that we have available in our store right now. And on the right hand side, we have the merchant category. In this case, since we're creating it for Google Shopping, these categories need to correspond to the Google Merchant Shopping categories. To do that, let's go ahead and do a quick Google search. I'm going to search up Google Product Taxonomy. Let's click that. This is the first link we're looking at. As you can see, under the Google Product Taxonomy, we have all the different categories available in Google Merchant category. Now all we have to do is find the category that's relevant to us and put that category in CTX Feed under the category mapping function. I should mention there's another way of adding categories apart from the list that we just saw. So let me show you. If I search up Google Merchant categories and I go into Google support, we can look at the format and we can see that you can either add the category ID or you can add it like we've seen before. If you want to find out the ID number of particular categories, click here and you'll have the list where you can see all the different categories and their corresponding IDs. For now, in this video, instead of using the category IDs, we'll just be using the categories. The first category that we have is uncategorized. This is the default category assigned to products that does not have any categories assigned to it. So for now, this is not relevant to us. Let's move on to the next one, which is clothing. Let's see if we can find the Google Merchant category for clothing. So I'll go back here. Let's do a quick search. Clothing. There we go. As you can see, it's falling under apparel and accessories. This is exactly what I'm looking for. So I'll copy that and go ahead and paste it back here. As you can see, all the subcategories has automatically gotten filled up. Let's see if we can find any of these subcategories in Google Merchant category. First up, we've got hoodies. Okay, let's come up here, search up hoodies. As you can see, nothing is found. So Google Merchant does not have a subcategory for hoodies. So if you go back to our category mapping, for hoodies, I'm gonna keep it under clothing. Let's look at t-shirts. So let's look for t-shirt, t-shirt, nothing's found. Let's put a dash here. Nope, nothing yet. Let's just try shirt. Football shirts and vest. No, that's not it. Swimming shirt. Okay, there we go. Under clothes and accessories, shirts and top. This looks like appropriate category. So let's copy that and paste it here. There we go. Next up, we have accessories. So let's have a quick look. There we go. This one looks like it. Let's copy it and paste it here. Similarly, I'll find categories for these two as well and fill them up. Once you have filled them up, go ahead and click on Save Mapping. There we go. Now our mapping is ready and set to go. Now it's time to use this mapping in our feed. So let's go to CTX Feed. Let's create a new one. Click on New Feed. United States is fine. For template, I'll use Google Shopping. Let's give it a name. Category test, XML is fine, cool. Let's scroll down. We've got product categories here, so we can see what the local categories are. Here, let's choose attribute, and we need to choose the new attribute that we've just created. Scroll down, there we go, Google Mapping. Let's use that. Let's scroll all the way down, update and generate this feed. Now let's take a look at what the file looks like. Now, if we take a look at our feed, we can see our product, which is t-shirt. Let's scroll down. There you go. This is the category. This is the local category. And here As expected, we can see our Google category. There we go. Here we've got our product hoodie, where the product type is hoodies. Since we didn't have that in Google, we just kept it as apparel and accessories clothing. Let's look at one last one. We can see we've got belt. The local category is accessories. Here we can see apparel and accessories, clothing accessories. Perfect. Everything is working as we have expected. There you go, guys. Now you know how to map store category to your Google merchant category. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.